I'm Annie Wallace. I graduated in 2014, and I'm currently on the first national tour of Disney's Aladdin as one of Jasmine's attendants in the dancing ensemble and understudying Princess Jasmine.
Hi, my name is Stephen Brower. I graduated from Texas State in 2015, and I'm currently on the Anastasia National Tour playing Dimitri, which is the role that I understudied in the Broadway production.
Hi guys, I am Ben Toomer, and I graduated in 2018.
Ooh, 2018. Mm-hmm. I'm Edwin, I graduated in 2016.
Yes, and we are on the national tour of
Beautiful, the Carol King musical.
Yeah. Hey, I'm Laura Sky Herman, and I am currently playing Ermengarde in the first national tour of Hello Dolly, woo! And I should have graduated in 2019.
I'm Daniel Z. Miller. I'm currently on tour with Anastasia, where I am in the ensemble, and I'm also the Dimitri understudy.
My name is Chris Clark. I am a 2019 alum of the Texas State MT program. I'm here on the set of Jimmy Buffett's Escape from Margaritaville. We're at the Fabulous Fox in St. Louis, Missouri, where I play Tully.
I'm Michael Burrell. I am a Bobcat class of 2017, and I'm currently starring as Henri Burrell in the international tour of An American in Paris.
Hi guys, I'm Helen Regula, and I am a 2016 grad, and I am currently on the SpongeBob musical playing the mayor of Bikini Bottom.
Hey, I'm Trevor James Berger. I graduated in 2018, and I'm currently playing Tony in the international production of West Side Story here in Tokyo, Japan.
Best part of the tour is seeing all these beautiful cities. You get to go and explore towns that you would have never even thought to go and visit. I'm looking at you, Burlington, Vermont.
You're getting paid to travel, whether it be the world or the states or whatever it is, and you get to see some amazing places.
Getting to bond with the cast, they're definitely your family out here, and having the show every night is like totally the best part. It's a blast.
We built such an incredible community. Within this cast, we've all become some sort of like family, specifically within the Drifters. We spent a lot of time with each other in rehearsals. And
so it was all of our time. I mean, not all of the time, but so much of the
exactly.
time.
Exactly.
A fun fact about me being on tour is that I'm actually traveling with Allie Hagerman, my beautiful wife. She happens to be working merch on the same tour, and we're both traveling together. It's great.
Our stage is 360 degrees around an audience section that's right in the middle. And that audience section, from scene to scene, is on a turntable that rotates and follows the action from scene to scene. So we have about 8 massive stages that wrap all the way around, 1,400 people sitting right in the middle, and then they follow us along on this crazy ride that is West Side Story.
Shout out to Greg Barnes for this incredible dress. He designed the costumes for Aladdin. This is the most beautiful dress I've ever worn and probably will ever wear. It probably costs more than my wedding dress will ever cost. It's 12 to 15 pounds because of all the hand beading. And every girl's is different, including the female swings, so it's always unique to the person, which is really cool.
We're down in the bowels, the basement of the Fox Theater, where there is just, you can see behind me, so many awesome wall tags from shows that have been here in the past. That's where ours is going. We're working on it right now, but it's really cool. I've found like a lot of Texas State alumni, like right in our deck here, Annie Wallace, Stephen Brower, and our very own Kaitlin Hopkins on these walls.
And then here we are in our beautiful theater.
What?
It's so pretty.
Look at this view, it's so ugly. There's Notre Dame. And then you just go to the right a little bit. Oh look, it's the Eiffel Tower.
First one is a group of things. It's what I call get me through the show kit. We've got some tea, today it's Throw Co. Shout out to Throw Co. We got some Fontas, major shout out to Fontas. Coffee to keep it going because it's a long show and you gotta stay hyped. But also we got a whole bunch of water. So that's thing one, it's a package. Thing two is my guitar. This is our rehearsal guitar. I play it for press events and I play guitar in the show, so I use it to warm up on in my dressing room. So that's thing two. Thing number three is just some good tunes.
My Pyramist steamer.
ginger shoes and my foam roller just to keep my body all right and tight and ready.
Yeah. Yes, I love that.
Okay, three things I need in my dressing room. A cork. I always warm up with it. It's so Kaitlin Hopkins. A beauty blender, which, you know, blends my beauty. And lotion, because I'm weirdly obsessed with having not dry hands. And Aveeno, I mean, come on, it's the best.
Hi guys.
Just adjusting my list.
Our faculty at Texas State has prepared us well to put us in scenarios where we have to learn things quickly. And I know a lot of times we are thrown into certain situations. It seems like every week we're doing a brand new show.
Literally, we did one today.
We did.
Cassie with the tap dancing was very helpful. My big number is a tap number. Michael pushing range and what I'm able to sing. BFA with just character development and acting the song and all sorts of things. It's kind of just something where you look back now and you're like, oh, all of the things I was taught are coming into play. Nothing was just for the sake of it. It's all very helpful.
I think what served me most in my career so far, having come from Texas State, is just knowing who I am as an artist and as a creator and a collaborator and what I want to say. Because it can get very difficult in this business when you feel like you have to fit into a box all the time or put yourself out there all the time. And I have the tools and the confidence to take care of myself in the face of rejection or what feels like rejection or failure all the time.
Michael Maresca's most favorite saying, which is the ability to fail forward. In my audition, I forgot all my words. I went up on all of my lines, but it was okay and it actually led to a lot of laughs. So thanks, Michael.
I would probably hone in on our one voice training. West Side Story is a beast of a score to sing, and playing Tony has challenged me in ways I never thought it could. But with our one voice training, we always put an emphasis on longevity and singing efficiently and speaking efficiently in ways that allow us to continue on with a run 8 times a week as opposed to just one night.
It's just easy peasy, probably day one, Jim Price's acting class, just listen and respond. You know, when you're doing 1,000 shows of something, you have to remember to stay present in every moment and really listen, and it'll inform you differently on every day.